This week's Ask Dr. Durie is a common question and comes from several patients who want to know if they're doing well, myeloma protein level is low, do they still need to continue to track any possible bone disease? And the answer to that is a definite yes, especially if there was any significant bone disease at the start of the disease or some has emerged during the course of the disease. It really, really is important to keep track of that. So how do you track that? Well, the main thing is to follow along from the initial testing that was performed. If you had x-rays at the beginning, then follow up on the x-rays. If you had MRI, CT scan, low-dose CT, or PET scanning with CT, then you need to be able to compare with that initial testing to see if anything has changed. Now, if there's a new area of pain, it may be that CT, MRI, or PET CT is necessary to investigate something new. However, the main thing is to have a plan with your doctor so that you know what are the regular follow-up testings that are going to be done to monitor your bones. There's absolutely no doubt that this is essential, because what we know is that, unfortunately, even although the myeloma protein may be really low or maybe even has gone away, we still know that myeloma can be a little bit sneaky, and it's very important to keep track of the bone disease. And so bottom line, absolutely set up a protocol with your doctor to follow up on the bone disease, whether it be a follow-up MRI periodically or CT scan or a whole body PET CT, if that is covered by your insurance. This should be done at least once a year in patients who have had bone disease, and obviously might be needed in between times if there's any question or concern. But please, do keep track of your bones. This is an area where there can be new problems, and it's important to stay ahead of the game and be alert to anything new that's changing.